ever. Sanders seems the one absolutely with the wind at his back this morning. Talk about the wind at his back and no need help smiling this morning. His campaign manager, Jeff Weaver, is here with me. And Jeff, it's great to see you. Thanks for coming in.
Nice to be here.
So it surprised a lot of folks last night what happened in Michigan.
The whole CNN panel, for sure.
Yeah, everyone fell on the floor and passed out. What surprised you most about last night?
Well, look, I think Senator Sanders really closed strong in Michigan. I think we've seen that in state after state. You know, a lot of our states that he has won by double digits. Only a week ahead of time, he was down in the polls. So the more people hear and see Bernie Sanders and his message talking about rebuilding the middle class, they respond.
But when you look at the math, it is, yes, it is a big win. And a psychological win, I think, is just almost as important right now. But when you look at the math, that's the thing that matters at the end of the day. She's still continuing to increase her lead in terms of delegates.
Right, but you have to look. So when we get through March 15th, which is coming up, we've got five big states coming up. At that point, only half of the delegates will have been chosen. And if you look at the calendar going forward from there, it gets increasingly positive for Senator Sanders. As you know, he's won states by double digits all across the country, from Colorado to Maine, in some cases by 30 or more points. And there are a lot of states that look like those states that are going to be coming up, and those kinds of margins are going to allow him to eat into that delegate lead. You know, she was very strong in the South. She was First Lady of Arkansas. She has a lot of relationships there. But we're almost out of Southern states. Mm-hmm. And outside of the South, Hillary Clinton has yet to show that she can win convincingly anywhere.
And Sanders said last night that he believes the strongest states are yet to come. That's exactly what he said when he came out.
Absolutely.
What states are you guys targeting?
Look, I think we're going to do well all up and down the West Coast. I think we're going to win California. I think we're going to win Oregon. I think we're going to win Washington. We're going to fight in New York. I think that's going to be a big showdown state in this. Wisconsin would do very well. There's six states after March 15th in March, Arizona, Utah, Idaho.
So all of them.
But all those states, we're doing very well in Arizona. The map just looks so much better for him after March 15th. You know, it really was front-loaded for her, frankly.
Let me ask you, though, another bit of good news, if you guys needed more from last night, is when you looked at the exit polls, it looks like you had your biggest support yet from the African-American community.
Absolutely.
In Michigan.
Yes.
But the exit polls show that African-Americans went for Hillary Clinton, though, still, in Michigan, 65% to 31%. Yes, I have heard Bernie Sanders even speak last night, trying to reach out and
Absolutely.
Speak to the African-American community, but she's still beating him,
right?
65 to 31.
No, that's true, Kate, and we're gonna do more work. But if you look at young African-Americans, it was basically split between Senator Sanders and Secretary Clinton. That's an amazing, amazing amount of progress that he has made in reaching out to the African-American community. And I think, you know, a lot of it had to do also with Michigan. You know, the black middle class in Michigan was really destroyed by these mm-hmm. trade deals that Hillary Clinton supported and the deindustrialization that followed. And they know that Bernie Sanders was the person who stood with them for decades on against these bad trade deals.
Let's talk about, since clearly you're a huge fan of polls now, after what happened in Michigan, let's talk about the newest polls that are just out from CNN in two key states.
Sure.
Here in Florida and in Ohio. Clinton in Ohio is up 30 points.
Okay.
Clinton in Florida is up 27 points.
Okay.
What do you say?
Well, she was up 30 points in Michigan.
Do you think
a week and a half ago?
Do you think the exact same thing's going to happen? Do you think you can pull out wins in both Ohio and Florida?
Well, I don't know if we can win everywhere, but we are going to have wins on March 15th. There's no doubt about it. There's five states: Missouri, Illinois, Ohio, North Carolina, and Florida. Are we going to win some of those states, frankly?
Do you believe these polls?
No.
You don't believe these polls. What do you think the margin is going to be? Give me a guess.
I think the race is much closer than that.
Single digits?
Nationally or in these states?
These states.
It varies state to state, obviously. We're doing stronger in some states than others. I can't give away the secrets.
That's what I'm asking for, obviously.
The state secrets, yes.
Even before last night, Hillary Clinton, she said on the stump one line that I've been repeating because it was really telling. She said the sooner that she becomes the nominee, the sooner she can turn her focus to the Republicans.
Well, we feel the same way. The sooner that Bernie Sanders is the nominee, the sooner he can turn his attention to the Republicans. Look, all the polling shows consistently that against all of the top Republicans, Bernie Sanders does better against them than Hillary Clinton does. That's just the fact in the polling. That's they're not my polls. So I think Democrats have to be really concerned that if you nominate Hillary Clinton, you look at Michigan, right, a state where she was way ahead and lost. You know, when Donald Trump goes in there and talks about her devastatingly bad record on trade, now his prescription for how to fix it is wrong, but his observation about what she did in terms of supporting these trade deals, which destroyed the economy in Michigan and places in Ohio and Illinois and other places, North Carolina, frankly, where the furniture industry all went to China, that's going to be a devastating attack against her, against which she has no defense. I mean, you saw the debate the other night. I mean, her only defense was to create a dishonest attack, which has been widely criticized around the country, about saying that Bernie Sanders didn't support rescuing the auto industry when, in fact, he voted to rescue the auto industry. I mean, that was her only. She has no response for why she allowed corporate interests to sell out America and ship our jobs overseas.
I can expect that that very similar message is something we will hear tonight, since it seemed to resonate with voters in Michigan and other states.
And it resonates because it affects people's lives directly.
Jeff Weaver, it's great to see you.
Thanks for
talking to you soon. Thank you so much.